In an earlier lesson, I mentioned there are two types of slurs, regular slurs and lip slurs. This is the first of two short video lessons about the lip slur. This first one is about small interval lip slurs that have no extra note between the two notes that you're slurring from and to. Lip slurs involve going from one note to another without changing your vowels or using your tongue. I'll give you an example here just so you can hear it before I talk about it. Okay, so those were all very small interval lip slurs. There are two things to remember when you're doing lip slurs. That is airflow and tongue height. If you say ah, e, ah, e, do that a couple times and feel what your tongue is doing inside your mouth. This is what you're doing when you're changing from a lower note to a higher note, whether you're tonguing or, in this case, whether you're not tonguing, doing a lip slur. The tongue height is crucial, as is the airspeed. So on the lower note, your tongue shape is more of an ah shape, it's more flat. On the higher note, it's more of an E shape, more rounded. The danger with doing this is moving your jaw. Ah, E, ah, E. You don't want to move your jaw. The jaw should stay completely still the whole time. And if you could see my jaw when I did those last slurs, you'll see that it doesn't move. So my tongue is moving inside my mouth from that ah, E, ah, E, but my jaw is not moving. I'll do it one more time so you can see it. So those were all short, small interval lip slurs. I would recommend if you're starting these to start on the higher note and going to the lower note. It's a little bit easier. And if you're really a beginner and you're not getting this, start from the higher note and try to gradually make that note go lower and lower and lower until it finally pops down to the note below. I'll give you an example of that so you can hear what it sounds like. It doesn't sound that great. So what I'm doing there is starting on an E shape inside my mouth and just gradually lowering my tongue to an ah shape. And eventually the pitch will just drop right down to the next note. As you do this more, that motion will become more quick and you'll get a smoother chain from one note to the next. So that's basically it. Practice it. There are a couple really good books to help you with this. The best one is by Earl D. Irons. I-R-O-N-S. It's called 27 Groups of Exercises. It has a whole bunch of slurring exercises, lip slur exercises that'll help with your flexibility. But you don't need a book. You just need your imagination and a bunch of notes and a trumpet. So I would recommend getting the book, definitely, but also creating your own exercises that use lip slurs. So practice those, keep at it, and good luck.